So, in the chapter extraction of metals, okay, or metallurgy, we have to extract metal, okay. So, from ore. Now we have to study the methods, okay. In previous class also we described in brief something, but there are only 5-step processes, okay. Whenever we want any metal from its ore, okay, first method is to crushing of ore, okay. I hope you understand the crushing of ore is very easy term, okay. Just crush the ore, okay, or break down into its small particles, okay, is crushing. First step for if you want to obtain, okay, metal from any of its ore, this is the first method. In second method, okay, you have to keep in mind these things. Sometimes questions also asked on the basis of them. So concentration of ore, okay. So if we talk about the concentration, it is the initial purification, okay. It means just we have to concentrate the ore, okay. Wash them, okay. You can understand that by this. So this is the very initial step of purification. Then what we have to do in third step is comes conversion of ore, okay, into its metal oxide, okay. Mainly our main aim is to convert that ore into its metal oxide, okay. Once it's converted into oxide form, it is very easy to reduce it, okay. So this is the third step. In fourth step, we have to do reduction of metal oxide, okay, into metal. So this is the our main, you can say that we want to get metal from its ore, okay. So we achieve it, and the process of reduction is removal of oxygen. You have to keep in mind these things, okay. Whenever reduction comes, it means removal of oxygen. Oxidation means the binding of oxygen. So we have to remove this oxygen, then we get metal, na? It is known as metal oxide. When oxide is related to oxygen, okay, when we removed it, we get only metal. So this is the main we have to achieve. Our target is to achieve the metal. So this is in impure form. Still it is in impure form there, but our 99% target will be completed when we do the fourth step. We get the metal, and just after that we do only refining and some purification processes, okay. So these are the 5 steps which is related to this chapter. That first is crushing, then concentration, then conversion of ore, then reduction, then refining or purification, okay. So it is a 5-step process. So in last week what we did, okay, you have to try to understand these things by these images. In first image, you can see, okay, first what we do the crushing we do, okay. Now in the second method, okay, first crushing we have done already. Now it comes second method is concentration of ore, or you can say dressing of that ore. So for this there are different techniques. First technique is gravity separation, okay. And you also knows that this is when you read out it, this is mainly based on the two types of things, hydrophobic or hydrophilic nature, okay. Sometimes this ore has the hydrophobic nature or hydrophilic nature. You already know that what it means by hydrophobic and hydrophilic, okay. Hydrophilic and hydrophobic, the terms which you see in the hydro, okay. Philic means loving, okay. So these things, whenever this term comes, it means if we talk about this is ore, this ore is hydrophilic, it means it loves the water, okay. And hydrophobic, it is come from phobia, okay. So when we talk about the phobic, so it will be you can say that it will want to just left the water, okay. hydrophobic and hydrophilic. So this activity, this gravity separation includes this type of nature. So they have different density. So one thing is that ore and impurity must have the different density. Their density will be different. That's why sometime, okay, this figure also given on your book, that whenever, okay, we use this method, this type of image or structure we have, okay, instrument we have, then we just pour water, okay, and ore with mix with each other. So if the density of this ore is higher, okay, it will be catches here, okay, in these sockets, and impurity as water will be washed away. Okay, so oppositely, if the density is lighter than water, then water will be here, and this we collect the ore here. Okay, it means not that always water will be flow down. So this activity or this method is used to the gravity separation. In this we use only different densities when. So if the second method we read about magnetic separation. Okay, in magnetic separation you see this type of graph. Mainly magnet, as you know that we use this activity for the type of ore which attracts towards the magnet. So this is the best example is iron. Okay, in this method we mix ore and impurity with each other. Okay, then pour just here. These are the wheels which is rotated that in the clockwise direction like this. Okay, so what it is happen when we just pass through it? So it is a magnetic wall. Okay, it is filled with magnet. So impurity will be falls down when it come here. Okay, so non-magnetic impurity will be falls down, and complete ore will be just stick here. Okay, you have to just understand on the basis whatever written on your book, just basis of this image. Okay, so this is a plate, and you can see that this is a magnetic plate. Okay, so iron, suppose we have to get iron from its impurity in its when it is in its ore form. Okay, so this iron will be stick here, and the impurities which will be non-magnetic, it will be fast down. Okay, so this is the second method of concentration. Remember, we are just using this method in the second step of extraction, which is concentration. And one other method, okay, this is known as froth flotation. Okay, as you know that oil and water are not mixed with each other. Okay, so we use this type of activity mainly for the sulfide ores. Okay, we use this type of activity. When you read out on your book, you understand that we use it for the sulfide ores. Okay, and this is the main thing which is just operate in the terms of ore and oil and water. Okay, suppose in this also this is a froth aggregate here. Okay, when we pass down this water here, and some impurity plus water will be mix here. Okay, then one float will be comes out. Okay, it is bulges out in the means of froth. Okay, so oil will be the ore here. Okay, suppose this is the ore. Okay, this is the ore, and it will comes upper side, and water due to heavy, okay, its density is higher, it impurity water will be falls here, it remains here. So we have to collect it. So you have to understand that these are the just techniques of separation. Okay, in which we have to take the ore. Okay, we have to remove the impurity, just for minor impurities in there. Okay, that's why it is the such concentration, second step it was. Okay, in next one more leaching. Okay, for this figure also not given on your, but you have to just understand it. It is based on the solvent nature. Okay, some are mixes with each other, and some ores are mixed with some chemicals. Okay, we just read about it. Okay, in the last class also. Is coming. This is the main step. Third step is coming of extraction of metals. Okay, so it is the conversion of ore. That is, we want metal oxide from its ore. Okay, so mainly there are two processes which include in that, roasting and calcination. Okay, this word will become when you read about it. So So roasting means when the heating in presence of oxygen. Okay, there is only difference in these two processes, that when we heat this metal, this ore mainly, in the presence of oxygen, it is called roasting, and when we heat it in the absence of oxygen, it is known as calcination. Okay, now one thing you have to understand, when we use these two processes, okay, roasting and calcination, when our ore is sulfide, okay, if we use roasting, when our ore is carbonate, we use calcination. Okay, the examples are also given here. Okay, suppose our ore is zinc sulfide, okay, in the form of zinc sulfate or sulfide. So you can see that we use this roasting process. Okay, these are both same process, in which because this is the presence of oxygen, so we just add O2 here, so ZnO, we get the ZnO. Okay, one more thing you have to understand, that when we use roasting, when we use calcination, this is also for other compounds also, but when you see there in this formula of this zinc sulfate, is no oxygen is here, so it need oxygen, na? So it need oxygen, so we just combine it with oxygen and we convert it into zinc oxide, which is our aim, to convert metal oxide. Okay, then carbonate, as you know that calcium carbonate, it is already has oxygen, okay, in its formula, so it does not need oxygen, so we do not use this roasting method, we use calcination method, in which we just directly heat it, okay, and it convert into CaO plus CO2, and you know that the process. Okay, so it converted into CaO, which is calcium oxide. Okay, after that, what we have to do in fourth step? In fourth step, we have to reduce of metal oxide. Okay, so reduction means to get metal, okay, we have to reduce its metal oxide, or we have to remove oxygen from it. Okay, so there are some reducing agent. If you see that carbon, okay, carbon monoxide, and this is in the form of coke carbon and hydrogen, so these three are mainly reducing agent, okay, which are just remove the oxygen from the metal oxide. If you see, when we react coke with the copper oxide, it converted into carbon monoxide, and we get that metal. Our main aim in the fourth step, to get the metal. Okay, so we get the metal by just combining them. Okay, when we react carbon monoxide with the copper oxide, it forms the carbon dioxide, and we get the metal, copper, and in the same way we get the copper. Okay, so but this is not a single method, as you apply for all the metals. Okay, but when, that's why you read that electrochemical series in this chapter also, because there is something which is in electrochemical series. So as you know that copper will be in the somehow in the last of the that electrochemical series, so it can easily, very easily reduce by them. Okay, these reducing agent can easily reduce. Okay, so we can get the copper by these three, any one of these three, when react with this copper oxide or just below them, so we use this method. But as you know that silver oxide and mercury oxide, okay, these are less stable. Okay, sir, if you talk about, because these are found very much below in the, or in the somehow last in the electrochemical series, so these are very less stable. Okay, so we directly heat them, okay, and convert it into the metal form. Okay, so we get the metal very easily. And one more thing which I want to tell you, that in this reduction of metal oxide, that why we are not use the copper, carbon, okay, carbon monoxide, hydrogen and ammonia for these things or these elements, because these are very reactive. Okay, and they forms oxide also, so they form the oxide which is very stable. That's why we cannot use these all elements for just reduce them. Okay, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, and so on, something these are the elements which cannot be reduced by these. Okay, so as they are very reactive. Okay, so I just tell you that in brief what you can capture in your mind, that if in exam asked copper, okay, lead, iron, okay, these three can be reduced by carbon, carbon monoxide, hydrogenate, ammonia, NH3. Okay, and zinc oxide can directly be react with this carbon, okay, coke, as it present in the, as you know that it is the in just somehow last in the table, so it can be reduced only by the carbon, okay, or in the coke. So you can easily reduce it, as you saw in the previous example also. Now a question coming that as they are very reactive, okay, and we cannot reduce them by the carbon, carbon monoxide, okay, hydrogen and ammonia. So what we have to do? So we have to do the process which you read in your last chapter, that is electrolysis. Okay, so that's why to reduce their oxide, suppose there is potassium oxide, okay, and bauxite, it is known as bauxite, aluminium oxide, the oxide of aluminium. So when we have to convert, okay, them in their metal form to get the metal, okay, from them, so we have to use that process, electrolysis. Okay, so these can be obtained or by the process of electrolysis. So for this you have to just remember, you can make any sort method, that which are the elements which is not reduced by the ordinary methods. We have to use only electrolysis for them, that is lithium, okay, potassium, barium, strontium, okay, and calcium, sodium, MgAl. So you have to understand them, and you can, if you remember, it is good. So mainly these are the related to electrochemical series which are found in the just above in the periodic table. Okay, these are the in electrochemical series, they are just below, mean that the lithium, potassium, barium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium. Okay, if you remember these also, it is much helpful for you. Now we move to the main step, okay, which is refining. Okay, in refining, it means we get the pure form of that metal. It means 99.9% we get the metal, which is in its pure form. Okay, so electro refining, as the terms you have to, refining means electro refining when it is presence of electric light, okay, or electric current. So it is known as electro refining. We already read about in the last chapter also in very detail. Okay, so this is the main thing. Whenever you read about the metallurgy, whenever you read about the electrolysis, okay, so what we have to do? Okay, we have to take a container and attach it with some type of battery, and not make not much, as you already read in the last chapter also. So what we have to understand, that we have to take two rods, okay, one is anode, one is cathode. Mainly the impure metal will be attached to the cathode, anode. Okay, anode means is plus charge, okay, and cathode is containing minus charge. You already understand it. And what we have to do, same process, okay, and the solution of also of that same metal, which is copper sulfate, okay, then electrolyte which we use, okay, it is of the same metal, impure metal, as you saw in the step, this is the step 4, impure metal is here. Then we have to understand that what are the processes will be take place here. Okay, as you know, we have to understand these things. Okay, sometimes students are forget, and just for you I make of some shortcut, that POA, understand PAO. Okay, whenever there is positive, as you know, I have to understand these things. Whenever you make electrolysis, you have sometimes students also confuse that what is, where it is a plus charge, where it is a minus charge. So whenever positive charge comes, it comes to anode. Okay, and if we take up talk about the anode and it contain the plus charge, it means always oxidation take place here. okay, oxidation process will be take place at anode. And whenever we talk about the cathode, you have to understand that one term, NCR, okay, negative cathode reduction. Negative cathode reduction, okay, you have to keep in your mind. Whenever we say about the negative charge, it means negative charge will be come only on cathode tube and it reduces the metal, okay. So reduction process will be take place here. So now what you have to understand that in anode, okay, copper will be as you easily understand that copper from this impure metal, okay, it will be comes as the oxidation process take place. Oxidation means what? Okay, loss of electron. So it lost it there, two electrons here, okay, and it comes down into its electrolyte here, and then this is in the form of positive ions now. So it have to attach this and it goes to the electrolyte, okay, and it goes to the cathode, okay, tube. Then what the reaction take place? So it means gain of electron, reduction is take place in that cathode. So we get the copper, and copper are deposit here, okay, copper are just deposited here. Where it is deposited? It's just deposited here, okay, and it gradually decrease in size and it gradually increase in size. So pure form of copper we will be get here, okay. So this is the same thing, same process of electrolysis. It is the last process, okay. So one thing also, okay, in this chapter which you have to read, that extraction of aluminium, okay, and its ore form is bauxite, as you see on the screen also, Al2O3.2H2O. It's formula is this, okay. So now we have to extract it. So how can we do, okay, as you know that first step is crushing, okay, and grinding. When we provide it heat, okay, it is vaporized, okay. When we provide heat for this bauxite, okay, it is the ore form of aluminium, it vaporizes, okay. And in second step, when we do purification, okay, only we can do purification of sand, okay, there's iron stainless, okay, which is known as tin in Hindi. But these all are not method, these are not suitable for the extraction of aluminium, okay. So for the concentration process, okay, one method you have to read in your syllabus, that is Baer's process, okay. In Baer's process, why this process is called Baer? Because it is given by the scientist Baer, okay. So when many scientists fail to concentrate that aluminium, okay, as you know that it needs so much of high temperature, I think 2200 degrees centigrade or 25 is given, okay. So that much of temperature is needed when we have to just forms its oxide. It is forms its oxide, aluminium oxide 1 to 8. So it takes two things are there, okay. First is it's very costly, okay, and it second is very time taking process. So what Baer suggested us, okay, so Baer suggested that we can use alternative methods, okay. So first thing he just do that same thing that you do in concentrate, okay, it also when it react it with sodium hydroxide, okay, bauxite react with hot sodium hydroxide, it forms sodium meta aluminate, okay. So what you can see that the impurity which is insoluble, okay, it just remain below when we use the concentrated method first process, okay, gravity separation. So impurity will be insoluble, it remains as it is. Then we have to do dilution, okay, for this sodium meta aluminate we do dilution, then we get the 1 ppt of this aluminium hydroxide, okay. Then we have in 1000 degrees centigrade when we ignite it, okay, when we ignite it or just you can say that burn it, it forms the alumina. Okay, sometimes this ask also the chemical formula of alumina is Al2O3. Okay, so it is the it means make them. Then what we have to do, then we have to do in concentration, it is a chemical or a leaching process. Okay, it is the ore form of that bauxite. Okay, and we use solvent, and it the temperature will be 140 degree centigrade, and the time is 2 to 8 hours. Okay, and the temperature for the dilution is 50 degree centigrade. Then we get the PPT. In third step, okay, now we get the aluminium hydroxide. Okay, then what we have to do, Al2O3, we get the alumina here. So we can, in third step, we can easily do roasting, or but we cannot do roasting here, okay, because it has oxygen is there, already oxygen there, so calcination also not possible because it needed so much high temperature. Okay, as you see there, this alumina, okay, what I am talking about, that Hall and Hewlett said that this alumina to reduce, okay, in aluminium we have to get the aluminium in last. Okay, so we have to do electrolytic reduction. If we follow the electrolytic reduction, what is the problem? One problem is that it molten stage is 2050 degree centigrade. Okay, that much of temperature for just molten this alumina. And when we mold them, it aluminium eventually vaporize, so we can't get this aluminium metal. Okay, then this Hall and Hewlett suggest us. Okay, so this is the Hall and Hewlett suggested how can we forms the metal oxide of aluminium. Okay, after to get aluminium from its metal oxide alumina. So he said that, and they said that in this alumina we have to add cryolite and fluorospar. Okay, so the formula of cryolite is Na3AlF6 and fluorospar is CaF2. Okay, it has to change in ions. So what is the benefit of this adding cryolite? So main thing is that in this reaction is cryolite, because it lowers the melting temperature of alumina is 950 degree centigrade. Now you can easily understand that in the normal process, when we just heat up this alumina, it take 2000 degree centigrade temperature, but it when we add this electrolyte, it just goes down, its melting point is 950 degree centigrade, and increase conductivity also, where it take